Okay, once again, we say good morning or good evening. We say there's no business like show business. There's no show as busy as today. Today is a busy show. I've got today the young man about whom it is said, it is rumored. In fact, it's a definite fact because Arsenio Hall told me that Tiny Tim got him his highest rating in recent days and nights. Tiny Tim is here today, and he is what you call a star attraction all over the world, as is Corina. Corina is the lady who's happening this year in the world of recordings and charts and hits and discos, and she is of the moment. Terry Waldo, who gives us ragtime and jazz and pop, and a group known as the Ordinaires, and the Ordinaires are not ordinary. They're sort of reinventing pop or rock bands, and they've got a hot video. Got a man today who is kind of revolutionizing the home video market. He's doing serious music, classical or concert music on home video. And the big question is, will it retain its excitement in the living room the same as when you're hearing it or seeing it live in the concert hall? We're going to have samples of all these things. I've got Morty Storm III, who is a young, this man. When he appears, the gates are stormed. He's a popular man. And I've got the matinee idol of movie going back in the 30s and 40s and 50s. His name then was Clifford Jones, correct? His name now is Philip Trent. You see him here with Buck Jones, a couple of Joneses, Clifford Jones and Buck Jones, and this young man is now a Jersey resident, a songwriter, and a playwright, and a charming man. I say to you, welcome to a jam-packed edition of the Joe Franklin Show. My anchorman is going to be one of the really top actors, a young man that I have admired. He played the leading part. He played the patriarch for 9 years on Ryan's Hope, Mr. Bernard Barrow, and there's an actor. Bernie Barrow, an old friend of mine, an old friend of yours. And the program starts like this. It's known as, what's the name of the show again? The show's called what? The Joe Franklin Show. And it starts like this. Stay with me. Be right back. But Mr., this is what they say, a group that's called The Ordinaires, but not ordinary, right, group?
No, hardly. No, Angela, we're really weird.
Yeah, we ask you, starting with Angela, who christened you with that name, Ordinaires? How did that name come into being?
It was an accident, and we needed a name very fast. We had already performed under a different name, and it was created in the last-minute rush as kind of a joke on, French vin ordinaire.
And you're out to reinvent the rock band business, Mr. Kurt Hoffman?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, not that I'm unhappy with it, but I think that we wanted to remake it in our own image. I mean, We're doing something that a lot of bands don't do, which is that we only do instrumental music, which I think there was a lot more instrumental music that got to be hits maybe, I don't know, 30 or 40 years ago, but now it's pretty unusual. Anyway, so that's part of what we do.
They are getting Bernard and Corina enormous ink, and part of their appeal, I think, is the fact that they use certain instruments which aren't normally heard in a rock band or in a pop band. Well, wow. What could be one of those instruments?
Well, we have a little string section. We've got two violins and a cello and a little sax section and a big rhythm section with two electric guitars, bass, and drums. And so it's kind of the big, peculiar orchestral concept. But it's a rock band.
We're going to have a sample on video pretty soon. It's a red-hot video, I've been told, right? Mm-hmm. Getting good airplay?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, now you're going to be seen all over the world, really.
Oh,
now you're going to be, that I guarantee you. Now, where'd I put that tape before? Where'd I put that pretty,
it's
pretty,
on your
pretty?
Right, on the
this,
piece of paper.
My friends, are you going to help me with the man's name one more time? Extraordinary. Now we're going to see a sample of the Extraordinary Ordinaires. Somebody wrote, if you're cooking while this is on the turntable, you'll whip up something you never cooked before. What critic wrote that?
Wow, I don't know. I our manager didn't forward that one to us. I guess it would have been too dissettling.
Wow, right. They say, play a record by the Ordinaires while you're cooking, and you'll whip up something you've never made before.
Well, I'll definitely try it tonight, yeah.
Want to try it right now, Bernard?
Yeah, let's go.
Want to sample, Mr. Mr. Ballant Vajonet, want to see a sample of the Ordinaire?
Absolutely.
And they're not ordinary. They're getting mass attention, and their videos. Has it got a name?
Well, this song is called Kashmir, and we're trying to do for Led Zeppelin what he did for Mozart in that last tape.
And it goes something like this by the not ordinary Ordinaires.
Thank you.
Can you believe the quality of today's videos? Are they incredible? I can't. Are we getting
editing.
Visual?
Great.
Everybody's asking about the gigs or the forthcoming performances by the Ordinaires.
Well, we have three performances coming up. One is October 26th, and it's at the New Ritz. And then there's November 8th at the Second Presbyterian Church, and that's in Newark.
Newark, yeah.
And then
we're playing at the New Music America Festival at the Brooklyn Academy of Music.
And I'll be at the whole three, I promise.
You're all invited.
On the 26th of
October. Gentlemen, they're not ordinary, no. They're incredible. This man is great. Corina is the queen of our panel whenever she's on the block, right, Corina? And I want to tell you that the excitement is mounting. We're about to meet the great Tiny Tim. I'll be in to see Beauty Marks, and the big party is only just beginning. Stay with us.